Hey guys, it's Rick Prepares and welcome back to my 316 Liverpool Corona Award. Last time I left off, I went on another rant because on Liverpool, and I think they finally listened to me. I'm sorry, I can't say it without my straight face. Yes, they did pick up a huge win over the week at the weekend against Aston Villa. I mean, like, who doesn't beat Villa now? Even Villa fans know they're fucked. So, yeah. That's not an accomplishment. That's... yeah. To be fair, Villa would have known they're fucked anyway. I mean, they didn't score against the most leaky defense in the Premier League. Like, I don't know how Jurgen Klopp hasn't called a goddamn plumber with how many goals our defense late. But Villa didn't score against us. So that's how bad Villa are.
Hi there again, Martin Tyler here. Alan Smith.
So yeah, sorry about that, Villa. Enjoy the chat. That's all I can say to you, unfortunately. Because I think you're pretty doomed.
They just love their clean sheets, don't they?
The game today, Liverpool against Sheffield Wednesday. This is the Liverpool side. Rafael Varane.
But who knows? Maybe this will turn them around. Maybe they can... I mean, they're still in the Europa League, which they're playing the first leg against Augsburg tonight, actually. Thursday, the 18th of February.
It's all about attitude, really, Martin, isn't it? How much those wide.
And of course, they have the up and coming Capital One Cup final against Manchester City, so two big matches on the horizon. Chance to progress in the Europa League and chance to get at the League Cup.
So the first goal.
Neither City nor Augsburg will be easy to beat, but if we can keep guys like Philippe Coutinho fit, then we'll have a very good chance. I mean, let's not forget how badly Philippe Coutinho embarrassed the Manchester City team when we played them in November, when we beat them at the Etihad. We embarrassed them. And Philippe Coutinho, along with his Brazilian brother from another mother, Roberto Firmino.
Nathaniel Clyne.
And maybe, just maybe if we get lucky, Daniel Sturridge won't get injured hurt again until after that match. Because we all know it's only a matter of time before Sturridge is back on the injury. Realist? So, the question is, how long can we get out of him before he goes back to the injured list? And can he win us some goddamn silverware?
But perhaps it's the extra workload. He feels that he wouldn't be able to do both. And his club job would suffer as a result. And I think the fans would be pleased about that if that was going to be the case.
Coutinho! He's kept it out.
Coincidentally, the League Cup was the last bit of silverware we won 4 years ago.
And what a goal!
When we beat Cardiff in the final.
Scored one similar to this myself, Martin. Good header to the keeper's right.
Wait. It was 4 or 6 years ago.
Restarting at 2-0.
Yeah. I'm not sure. No, it was 2012. Yeah, it was 2012. Not sure why I was thinking it was 2010 there for a second.
Correa.
Maybe a little... Where the hell is 2010? Final as well? I genuinely don't remember, to be honest with you. It was definitely 2012 when we won the Capital One Cup under Kenny Dalglish.
Well, scoring in any game is worthy of celebration. When you get two, it is special. And he is feeling that special delight at the moment.
Oh, it's a great finish to take the keeper out of the equation. I mean, the keeper had no chance there. Bottom corner.
And Liverpool putting on...
So, yeah. If we do win it, it'll be the first time in 4 years that we've won a trophy, and it'll be the same trophy we won 4 years ago. Ironic, but of course Manchester City will have something to say about that. Of course, the reigning Capital One Cup champions, aren't they? Yeah, they are. Maybe was it? No, that was 2 years ago, wasn't it?
They've drawn their last three.
I can't remember who they beat last year. I know they beat... I think it was them? No, it was Chelsea who beat us. Is it Chelsea or is it Man City who are a little currently cup champions? It might be Chelsea, actually.
I have to say, it's so one-sided today, but all...
No, it is. It's Chelsea. Shouldn't they be us last year in the semi? Why don't I remember any of this? I don't know. I can only speculate something that happened.
The goalkeeper who's asserted himself from the corner. The defenders love that.
In reality. I mean, I knew my memory wasn't the best, but goddamn, that's embarrassing. In any event.
Well, logic tells you if you can score that many goals in one half, maybe the opposition can score the same in the second.
So, focus on the second half here against Sheffield Wednesday, already 4-0 to the good. Neymar or Correa, and Tillman's getting the goals.
Towards Neymar. Oh, he's
is Neymar about to get his second? Yes, he is. This might be the most interesting thing about this season. The battle for top goal scorer between Neymar and Correa.
Goal news from
be a very interesting battle. Neymar versus Correa.
Alexis Sanchez. A stunning diving header to round off a great team move. 51 minutes played. 2-1.
Cheers, Alan. Now they've won the ball back and trying to make something of it quickly.
Chris Correa. Would I think Correa is still 1-0 ahead because he got two goals in this match as well. So unless Neymar scores again, Correa's going to stay ahead.
Well, he's got support here.
Neymar's looking.
Well, that's a good block.
He won a corner. Royce. In. Neymar! Westwood is equal to it.
on EA Sports very soon. The Champions Cup fixture for Liverpool, they'll be hosting Inter.
Yeah, high quality fixture this one. There won't be much quarter given.
Not a good challenge by the defender. They've coped with it.
Oh, Crown's got himself his after. Both men on it.
That will be Liverpool's throw-in. Nathaniel Clyne towards Neymar. He might be through.
Poor touch from Neymar. Gonna deny him his hat-trick, for now anyway.
Really strong tackle.
Really, Bale? God damn it. Hey, he made up for it by intercepting the throw. Well, cuts it back to no one in particular because no one was paying attention.
Referee blew. Very well done.
Good team.
Side of the head as well as the outside. Good pass. Johnson, and he's presented the ball to the opposition. Royce, throw in for Liverpool.
I'll take the throw.
Marco Royce.
Royce. Team. Rodriguez.
Spread it out wide here.
Ah.
To get some width into this attack. Now we've only got 4 minutes remaining in the match. Out for a throw.
Throw. Getting close to the end of the match now.
Great work by the goalkeeper. The ball is hit, sure he's protected it.
I don't think anyone will be getting their hat trick unless the keeper makes a mess of the kick out. No.
Marco Royce.
Royce. Oh, nope. No, there's no time for head out time. That's not necessary. Oh well. Still one goal in it. And I gained 3 points on Everton because they lost to Chelsea! I wish I could tell you how you work. You're still in my plans, but no offense. Sorry. Play him for the game against Inter. already 2 points clear. This put me 5. Now I need only one more group stage win to guarantee my progression. Sure that I wasn't gonna get updates from the other game. I'm not interested. It doesn't affect me at this point. Okay, enough of this running around with rosy crap.
Alan Smith alongside me. Alan, this is a very intriguing group. We're had a couple of games for each club now. Now we're on to match day 3. Beginning to shape up.
Yeah, I think so. The group does begin to take shape and we'll begin to see who's going to be the favourites to top it.
This is the Liverpool side. This is Inter's lineup. Samir Handanovic starts in goal. Freddy Guarin plays alongside Ananis in the engine room. In attack, Stevan Jovetic starts. He was man of the match last time out.
Straight off Santon. My new age. He's actually retired in real life.
About him finishing his career.
I mean, only he knows when it's right. He might be feeling his body. But, you know, you need to think long and hard before making such a big decision.
Haider. Ananis.
Yeah. What's that?
It's a real tussle between the two of them to try and get the ball.
Just managed to keep that in.
The ball here.
I am not sure. Straight ahead. Damage.
Attacking well here.
Right again.
And the cross coming in.
Bring it. Yes, he's not offside. I was legit worried he was going to be offside, but no, it's 1-0.
Liverpool have got the goal.
It's come in from a long way out. And for
5 point gap at the top of the group. Here I come. And that's his third Champions League
goal. So the first goal, it's 1-0.
Solid. Running in.
If you look at the coach,
looking for a bit of deja vu. Origi's in the box again. Oh, he's going for another header.
Coming up. To get the throw. Stefan Jovetic. Davide Santo. Foul against Liverpool.
I don't see what I did wrong there. I was challenging for the ball. I didn't foul him. Despite what you think you saw, ref. What is it with these referees and see?
He's cut out the pass.
And them seeing things I clearly can't. I mean, they must see the least amount of contact you can put into a challenge. And he's giving that as a foul. That's what I'm going to assume he's doing. Because otherwise he should not be giving fouls against me, because I'm not doing anything wrong.
That's well wide. We can see it another time, Alan, this vital match-leading goal.
Did I go down from Pollitt?
Taken from them, they've lost it now.
I don't know. Ball to Origi. Well, well defended by Marleal. Probably said his name wrong, to be fair.
At the moment, it's looking quite
there
good.
He is again. Tindadir. Sorry. He's called him Tinder. No, he's not an online thing. It's like.
Hernanes.
Wilson.
A little too eager to get in.
Briggy is offside.
Crowd maybe expected a bit more, but it's two added minutes.
Wilson.
Molinaro.
Ooh, was looking for an AI in Nacho. Couldn't find it. Him was well defended, to be fair.
That's half time.
That's the half time whistle. Halfway to a 5-point gap at the top of the group. Nice.
Third match, remember, in the group stage of the Champions Cup.
Seems to be one or two nerves about in that first period, but I think it'll open up a little bit.
Divo Origi. Well, they're back defending and they've cut the pass out there. Maybe that will ease the pressure. There goes the cross. And he's kept the ball out of the penalty area with that block, the defender. And that will be a corner for Inter. Smart work by the goalkeeper from the corner.
Close to my goalkeeper. Come on, Jordan.
Coming up for you, of course, on EA's.
Wow, that's a foul.
That's a foul by him.
And a yellow card for Stefan Jovetic.
How important he is to them.
Unknown Manchester City striker, I want to say. I don't. I think that's the greater has left City. And Jovetic is still on loan. But there might be an option to buy.
Liverpool will get the throw.
Poor kick out from Handanovic there.
Molinaro.
Oh! Almost. That was almost a horrible mistake by the embryo. It was like Ambrose. I mean, where if the D stood for King? Real
good contest between these two as they jostle for possession.
Ambrosio. This is it to Brannigan. Moreno.
Now Wilson.
Wilson.
There's the ball in.
Whoops it in. Origi! 2-0! I'm definitely going to be within one win of qualification. Two goals from Divock Origi. He two headers as well. And assists for Brannigan and Wilson. Everything is going well. Everything is very much going well. Oh, and they're giving the ball away and, you know. Oh, yeah. I was just about to say, is that not a foul, ref? Come on. Even if they pay you, you can't ignore an obvious pass.
The ambition almost paid off. Didn't think he was going to go for goal there, but he did. And yeah, as you say, not too far away.
Why is Murillo up front? Have they gone all our attack? Because there's a problem with that. That leaves you a bit open for me to do that. Divo Origi gets his hat trick. And it's 3 points wrapped up.
What a day he's having.
We shouldn't go all our attack. I mean, Murillo is way too far front. And that leaves a gap in the back for Origi. He did it. There's this force through who he gets the ball from Nacho, and it's 3-0.
I don't think we expected this. Such a one-sided affair, but look at the scoreline.
I mean, 9 minutes after going 2-0 down, they go on all-out attack, which would be the only explanation for why Murillo was as far forward as he was.
I like the look about Liverpool today. Haven't been any phases in the game where they've... Oh, he's true! Shots on...
Origi! It's 4-0! Are they still on all-out attack or something?
It's another great goal.
Seriously, where are the defense? I mean, that's Warren and Jason Origi. And he's a good player, but come on. He's not exactly who you'd want in that position. You'd want your central defenders.
A very comfortable margin for victory. Can't really be any comeback in the time that we've got left. With such a difference between the two teams. 4-0 here, almost time up. What does this mean for the next...
Oh! Unless they do something like that, Vidic with a poor touch. He might get away with it. I fouled him. Brilliant. Oh, he got away with it.
Fans are absolutely loving it.
Well, they've been right behind their team from the very off. And that team has responded to that support.
And it's going to be a minimum of
3 minutes to be played. Right.
And it's Wilson. Now the shot!
Oh, just over the bar from Wilson. Good young player.
Stefan Jovetic.
Player I've been bringing up through the youth academy. Finally got him ready.
There is the final whistle. As a match, it was rather one sided.
This was actually his debut. So, very good. And very good. Hello, Rome. Player for anything. And it's just. And a very close call shot. So, not bad for your first game. Not to mention, of course, win. Gotta remember the win. Chelsea are up to second now. 7 points behind me. See what they can do with that. my money's gonna be on absolute nothing. But I guess we'll wait and see. Who knows? Maybe Chelsea will prove me wrong. Maybe they'll prove me wrong. So, I hope you enjoyed. Make sure to smash the like button if you did. Subscribe for more videos. And until next time, I want to thank you all for watching. I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.